brethren, count it all joy when you fall into divers temptations, knowing that the trying of your faith worketh patience, but that patience have a perfect work in you, that you may be entire, complete, lacking in nothing. And so we thank God for his word, a powerful word. You would think it was written yesterday, but this is from James the apostle. And you know, Jesus said that in this world, we're gonna have tribulation, but be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. Saints, it's time for us to just hold on to God's unchanging hand, to stand on the word of God, to pray without ceasing, to expect miraculous things from the Lord our God, because without him, we can do nothing. Without him, we would fail. Without him, we're like a ship drifting without a sail. So I just want to admonish the saints tonight to let's just keep trusting God in the midst of it all, in crucial times, in times like we've never seen before, a time of uncertainty and change. And we're looking at so much that's going on, sickness and disease here, there, and everywhere. And so it's praying time. So saints, be blessed of the Lord. We just honor God. We thank him for who he is and what he has done in our lives, what he's promised us that he's going to do. We give him all the glory and praise. So let's continue to lift one another up. Here we are, we're coming up on Memorial Day this next week, Monday, which we'll be celebrating and making mention of on Sunday, midday worship, remembering those who have gone on the other side, those who have sacrificed, who have given the ultimate sacrifice for our freedoms here, those in military service from way back until even present time. So we never want to forget what the Lord has done for us and what he has allowed others to do and to stand for. So we just thank God. And I know it's a hard time. Memorial Day is a hard time for so many people when they begin to reminisce and to think about mom or dad or sister or brother or son or daughter that's gone on the other side, and find ourselves at the gravesite polishing the headstones or placing flowers. And it's good to have a memory. But Paul tells us in 1 Thessalonians 4:13, that we should not sorrow as those that have no hope. We have hope in Christ Jesus, and we know that we will see our loved ones again. So while we're still here and the blood is yet running warm in our veins, let's occupy until Jesus comes. Amen. May the Lord God bless you, is my prayer.